Solve the differential equation d square minus 4d plus 3 acting on y equals sin 3x cos 2x. When you replace capital D using m and equate the RHS to 0, you get the auxiliary equation as m square minus 4m plus 3 equals 0, whose roots are m1 equals 3 and m2 equals 1. Since the roots are real and distinct, we have the complementary function obtained as c1 e raised to x plus c2 e raised to 3x or c1 e raised to 3x plus c2 e raised to x. Since we have a non-homogeneous type of differential equation with the RHS as a function on independent variable x, let us consider r of x equals sin 3x cos 2x. We have by trigonometric identity 2 times sin a cos b equals sin of a plus b plus sin of a minus b. Hence, if you rewrite the RHS as 1 by 2 times 2 times sin 3x cos 2x, we have 2 times sin 3x cos 2x rewritten as sin of 3x plus 2x plus sin of 3x minus 2x, which equals sin 5x plus sin x. Hence, we have the given RHS can also be written as 1 by 2 times sin 5x plus sin x. Notice that this format is exactly the same as this RHS. Required general solution will be sum of complementary function and particular integral. If you split the particular integral as pi equals pi1 plus pi2, where pi1 equals half times 1 by f of d acting on sin 5x and pi2 equals half times 1 by f of d acting on sin x, we have general solution will be y equals cf plus pi1 plus pi2. Let us evaluate pi1, which is 1 by 2 times 1 by d square minus 4d plus 3 acting on sin 5x. Since we have r of x, or the input given to 1 by f of d is a trigonometric function of the form sin ax or cos ax, we have capital D square, which can be replaced by negative of a square, where a is the coefficient of x which appears inside sin x or sin ax or cos ax format function. Here we have phi is the coefficient of x which appears inside the sine function. Hence, you can replace capital D square using negative of phi square. Thus, we have the denominator obtained as negative 4d minus 22. When you take negative sign outside from the denominator, it becomes negative of 4d plus 22. In order to transform the denominator to the format a square minus b square, we will multiply numerator and denominator using 4d minus 22. Thus, we have, once this negative sign is taken to the numerator and we have multiplied 4d minus 22 to both numerator and denominator, we have pi1 equals 1 by 2 times negative of 4d minus 22 upon 4d the whole square minus 22 the whole square, which acts on sin 5x. Now the denominator is of the format a square minus b square, which equals 16d square minus 484 here. Now we have d square again getting replaced by negative of phi square, because this is of the form 1 by f of d acting on sin of ax, where a equals phi, which is the coefficient of x. When capital D square is replaced by negative of phi square, we obtain the new denominator as 16 times negative 25 minus 484. Negative upon negative becomes positive. In the denominator, we obtain 884. Now we have pi1 equals 1 by 2 times 1 by 884 multiplied to 4 times derivative of sin 5x minus 22 times sin 5x. We have derivative of sin 5x equals 5 times cos 5x. That is, 4 times derivative of sin 5x equals 20 times cos 5x. Thus we obtain pi1 equals 1 by 2 times 20 cos 5x minus 22 sin 5x upon 884. Similarly, we can compute pi2 equals 1 by 2 times 1 by f of d acting on sin of x. Here we will replace capital D square using negative of 1 square, which is negative 1, which will give us the new denominator as 2 minus 4d. In order to transform the denominator to the format a square minus b square, we will multiply 2 plus 4d to numerator and denominator, so that numerator becomes 2 times sin x plus 4 times derivative of sin x divided by 4 minus 16 d square, where d square is again replaced by negative of 1 square. New denominator is 4 minus 16 times minus 1, which becomes 20. In the numerator, we have 2 times sin x plus 4 times cos x. Thus, pi2 equals sin x plus 2 times cos x upon 20. Hence, the required general solution will be Cf plus Pi1 plus Pi2.